Hi there guys, welcome to my third tutorial. I'm going to show you how I edit my black and whites. My aim for black and white images is not to have a flat image, but a more 3D sort of image. So this is more contrasty, it's more punchy. So I'll show you how to do it. So like always, I start off with duplicating my background layer. So first of all, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how just desaturating the image to black and white is no good. As you can see, it's a very flat image. It doesn't jump out at you. It's not contrasty. It doesn't give you that nice punch which you're looking for in a black and white image. And So this is where the fun stuff begins. I'm going to show you how I edit my black and whites. I start off with a small S curve to bring out all the bring out some more contrast in the image. I now create another S curve, just a normal curve layer, and bring out the blacks. Just like this. Just moving the slider up slightly. Now I do a black and white adjustment layer, and I fiddle with the sliders on the right hand side to enhance some of the features in the image. So skin tone has a lot of red and yellow, so if I bring them down a little bit, it makes the skin a bit more contrasty. So I'm just fiddling with it just to see what suits this image. Now the background is quite blue. So if I bring that up and down, it'll change the blues in the image. His eyes are also blue, so I'm looking out for that as well. So I'm just gonna adjust the gent to bring down the blacks in his lips. Just slightly there. I think there it looks good, yeah. So when I'm happy with what I do, I'll go on a levels adjustment, and I pay attention to the left and the far right of the levels adjustment panel. I bring it in slightly to enhance the blacks, then I bring in the white area to increase the whites. Not too much though, otherwise you will blow out the image. So just adjust it to see something which you like. I like it around about, I think that looks quite nice, I think, yeah. Let's have a look. So this is the flat, just desaturated image, and this is the after. Before, after. As you can see, it's already quite punchy and contrasty compared to if you were just to desaturate the image. Next, I'm going to do a new layer. And I'm going to fill it with 50% grey for dodging and burning. The reason why you need to dodge and burn on these images is it's basically you're just trying to create a more 3D look to the whole image. Like where it's dark, it's, you know, make it a little bit darker, but only in certain areas, make it light in certain areas. With this way, you have more control of the image. So now that I've created it, put it to soft light blending mode. Duplicate the layer because you want one for the darks and one for the highlights. So I'm just call that one light and call this one darks. Now you got to select the brush tool and make sure that you have, I like to start on from the darks. So brush tool, make sure you have black selected and make sure the opacity is down to 10%. Make sure it's a soft brush. And what I'll start doing now is I will start just painting in like the areas which I want to be darkened. So I want the eyebrows to be darker. This is really nice because it brings out the eyes a lot more if you make the eyebrows darker. just the like the sort of eyelashes sort of area around the eyes. The shadow on the nose. and also the side of the face. You only want to make it, you know, a little bit darker, not too much darker, just a little bit darker. So just doing a bit underneath the neck area as well. Now I'm gonna move on to the highlights. So change the color to white, and I just start painting in areas which I want brighter. So I want to paint the eyes in to make it just a little bit brighter, bring out his eyes a little bit more. Don't overdo the white part of the eyes though, because it can look really fake and crap. So yeah, be careful when you're brightening the eyes. Only do it to a certain amount. I'm just gonna highlight the little triangle sort of light fall off on his underneath his right eye. So I'm just gonna show you what they look like with these layers on. Before it was just a crappy black and white desaturated image, and after, before, after. So you can, as you can see, it's much better. It's more contrasty, it's more punchy, and it just springs to life. I hope this helped, guys. If you like this video, subscribe and like my Facebook page. Thank you.